This morning on today's healthcare changes for 2011, from the coverage to the cost, we have the facts you and your family need to know for the new year. Andrew Rubin is the host of Healthcare Connect on Sirius XM Radio. Andrew, welcome back. Good to see you this morning.
Good to be here.
Let's talk about the changes. First, Medicare prescription changes. They have changed, if I understand it right, they cover to a certain point, then they stop. And that's always been referred to as the donut hole.
Exactly.
Where you're caught it on your own. What changes now in the new year?
Very confusing for a lot of seniors. This year, 50% of the cost of the drugs that you buy when you get into the donut hole are covered under health care reform. So once a senior enters that hole, 50% of the drug costs that they're responsible for are paid for. 7% discount on generic drugs.
So what's the trade-off? Will the premiums go up for some people?
Well, Medicare premiums in general, if you make under $85,000 as an individual or $170,000 as a couple, they stay the same. But for anyone above those thresholds, it goes up a little over 4%, 4.4%.
You know, one of the arguments when this was all being worked out was concerned that some doctors would stop taking Medicare because they thought the fees would be reduced by all this. Is that still a threat?
Well, there's two things going on. One is there was big fear that the fee schedules would be cut in general. Congress fixed that last year. Going forward, so the fee schedule is the same for next year, and then there's a 10% enhancement for primary care services. So any physician who takes care of Medicare physician who takes care of a senior will get a 10% bump on their primary care fees.
Now, there's also a big change in preventative care, I know, that will cover certain procedures. Does that start this year?
That starts this year, too. Now, remember, the whole point of health care reform, there's lots of points of health care reform, and one of them is to reduce costs in the system. And there's belief that if you get a preventative exam and there's no coinsurance or copay amounts about it, you'll go for that exam and take better care of yourself. That starts this year as well.
Right, but the preventative care, colon cancer screening, mammograms, that sort of thing.
All those things are covered with no copays and coinsurances.
Yeah, what other changes can folks look for now that we've started the new year?
So a lot of the provisions kicked in this past September, but based on how the law was written, for most of us who get our health care insurance through our employers, those rules start when the new plan year begins, which is January 1st. So covering your children up to age 26 on your health insurance plan, you can't deny children with pre-existing conditions any health care coverage, these preventative things that we've been talking about. A big change is flexible spending accounts. Now you can no longer buy over-the-counter medicines with tax-free money.
Right, you have to have some kind of a prescription for what's traditionally over-the-counter.
Exactly.
But this whole thing is going to roll out, is it up till 2020, if I'm correct, right?
The donut hole rolls out, healthcare reform rolls out over many years.
Right.
The donut hole for Medicare will close by 2020. So each year going forward, it shrinks a little bit in terms of the amount seniors have to cover. The big changes in healthcare reform, when people no longer can get denied for pre-existing conditions, when you'll be able to buy your healthcare insurance on these state exchanges, the individual mandate, which was a big topic this past year,
right.
That starts in 2014.
And for folks who have been following the news, there was a court ruling recently that suggested at least part of this health care bill was unconstitutional. That doesn't change anything right now.
The implementation continues. The Supreme Court will decide that in the next couple of years. Now, if that it's the individual mandate provision. If that is overturned by the Supreme Court, health care reform has some big challenges.
That would be the requirement that we all have insurance,
that's correct.
And that's something we'll see it play out over the years to come. Andrew
Rubin,
good to have you on. Thanks very much,
good
and Happy New
here.
Year to you.
Happy New Year.
All right.